In my area, some people have started with the renovation work, and again the same noises of the traffic and the honking going on, the construction work. I was so enjoying Mother Nature, seriously. Hey my loves, what's up and welcome back to the Trend Diaries. I'm Nidhi, and in today's video, I'm back with another Nykaa haul. Half of the order was placed just before the lockdown and my packages were stuck, as you might be knowing if you follow me on Instagram, but later on during the corona time I did get it. And the second package was ordered recently because I was just done with all my moisturizers, my toothpaste, my brushes, and so I had to order some essentials, and I was in the safe zone. I mean, I am in the safe zone, so I did place them. But definitely I would suggest, if you are getting anything, please take care of yourself while you're handling those packages. Let them be out in the gallery untouched for 2 to 3 days, and then later when you're just removing your products, sanitize everything and throw off all the packages and the wrap. That I'm gonna do with this also, but I have sanitized everything, even the boxes, just because I had to show this for the video purpose. Anyways, with all the traveling now done, let's begin with what all I got. And as you know, Nidhi gets less skincare, less essentials and more of makeup, and that's exactly what you're gonna be seeing in this video. So if you want to know what all did Nidhi get, then please continue watching. So like to say that there's a giveaway going on my channel, which is Sugar's makeup giveaway. So if you haven't yet participated in that video, I would leave the video link in the description box. You can go ahead and participate in that video. Results will be announced on 4th of June, where 3 lucky winners would get Sugar makeup hampers. So do participate, and my 25,000 giveaway winners will be announced soon, because I was waiting for this lockdown to get lifted so that I can ship out those parcels. I do not want those parcels to get stuck just like my order. So too much of rambling, let's begin. Mera brush kharab ho gaya tha, and so I had to get a new toothbrush. So I got this pack of 4 from Oral-B, which is a value pack, they say. And so I got this one is Gaia, because I am currently using it. So this is the toothbrush set that I got. Let me show the essentials first. The next product, due to washing my hands n number of times thanks to corona, I was using moisturizers and body creams like crazy, and so I was done with almost all that I ever had, and so I had to get some. So I thought of picking up this. This is the Johnson's baby cream, and I don't know why, but I felt like I should give this a shot, and so I got this. Now that we're talking about skincare, I also got these two travel kits from Face Shop, and the first one which I've got here is the Twinkle Party by Dr. Belmer, and this is how it comes. Now this one was an offer. It does retail for 795 rupees, but that it was for around 500 and something, and so I got this. And this is how it looks. You get a toner, an emulsion and a cream. So everything is travel size, okay? But I did try it twice. I did not see a lot of difference with this, so I am still skeptical about this, but I am gonna give it a fair shot and then let you know what I felt about this. Second one, but actually this was the first one that I'd ordered, and this one was stuck due to the lockdown, but this retails for MRP 650, and I purchased it at 650 itself, because this goes out of stock like that. So I grabbed it ASAP that I saw it in stock. So this is basically the chia seed travel kit, wherein you get a hydro toner, hydro lotion and the chia seed creme, like this, in this small tub. I have finished this up completely. Nothing is left, nothing. This stuff, you guys, it is so good. It is so good, actually so good, especially the hydro cream. But I feel I'm so damn broke. Whenever I add the full size of this to my cart, I again end up removing it, because it's way too expensive for me currently to buy it, and that's the reason why I bought this instead. But this is really, really good. I could actually see my skin, you know, feeling a lot more supple, softer and hydrated, because I am extremely dry skin type, and this was actually, you know, locking the moisture into my skin, and I was loving the way my skin was responding to this. But sadly it is done. I don't really have it. I just have some of the hydro toner and the hydro lotion left, like just small amounts, but I love this. If you're looking for good, lightweight, yet moisturizing skincare, then definitely try this travel size first, because why to invest into something that you are not sure whether it would work or not for your skin. So I would recommend to try out the travel size first. Moving on to makeup. Firstly, I got this. This is the Nykaa Matte Last Liquid Lipstick in the shade Jhumki. On my Instagram, I did ask my followers whether anybody did own this shade, and I got so many DMs with photographs, screenshots, and you know, I was flooded and I was feeling so happy because Friend Fam is always there for the rescue. But I ended up buying this. I was confused between this shade and the shade Kashi, but I ended up picking Jhumki. This shade, you guys, is such a pretty purple, grey toned purple. That's the correct way to describe it, but sadly it washes me out. I wasted my money. Oh my god. If I were like 2 or 3 shades lighter, this would definitely look fab on me. So if you're like medium skin tone, NC20 to NC35-ish, this is gonna look fab on you. And that is the shade. It's such a pretty mauve purple with grey tones to it. But on me, dude, no. A clear no. After that, Nykaa had an offer for buy one get one, and so I picked up 2 of their nail paints. I initially had just 1 nail paint from them, a pastel pink kind of shade, which I had got actually free with my order. That was the most pathetic nail paint I'd ever tried, because after 6 hours, you know, after 6 hours of application, even after 6 hours of application, it was smudging. I mean, like, what? And so I was very skeptical, but I thought to give it a shot again, and so I got both of these. I am a pastel lover, and so I got this shade, which is Tall Timber 197, and the second one is Ocean Mist 182. Tall Timber is a beautiful leaf green shade. I wasn't expecting, but it does have a slight sheen shift, a green color, but it is not at all visible. Like if you come really close, like 24 centimeters, you know, to your eyes, and then you can see the shift. And the second one over here is a very beautiful whitish blue, just like I wanted, and so I got this. So I also have the K-Beauty ones. They are good, but I don't know why they just do not last. Like immediately on the second day, the nail paint starts to chip. Like, come on, dude, even my TS nail paints last for 4 days straight and then it starts chipping. But the K-Beauty one was expensive, but it was chipping, and I really loved her shade range, and so I was kind of eyeing this kind of color, but I thought why not to try out this one, and I love it. And these ones, comparatively to the older Nykaa nail paint that I had, the formula in this is so better. Yeah, they still chip, like after application, after like 3 hours even, it got removed because I was trying to open up a lid of one product. But still, these are way better in formula than the older Nykaa nail paint that I had. I am wearing the shade Tall Timber right now on my nails. It's so beautiful. So these are the 2 nail paints that I got. And I ordered another Rad Rouge blush shade from LA Colors. But look at the packaging, dude. It looked like it is Adam Baba ke zamane ka blush. It looks so old and yuck. When I saw it, I was like, मैंने ये सेल में नहीं लिया है, क्या है? And the packaging, dude, like, ew. And it has so many scratches on it. I don't think it is quite visible. So that is the blush shade. A mirror and a brush right down there. Isn't the shade beautiful? I am wearing it on my cheeks right now. This is in the shade Icon, and it looks like a pretty matte shade. It does have slightest bit of sheen to it, but you know, if you have tried the pearlescent pink from Wet n Wild, it is not that kind of sheen, because that is literally visible. I am wearing it on my cheeks right now, but it is not very prominent at all, because I personally do not like that kind of finishes in my blush. And this is how the shade looks. Very beautiful everyday nude kind of blush shade. I loved it. And moving on to this pouch, this has all of the lipsticks that I have shopped recently. If you do not know, I do have a series of lipstick swatches on my channel, and many of you guys requested for mauve pinks and mauve purples and muted mauves, mauve browns, and personally I did not find any good videos online, so I thought I'm gonna find some really good mauve shades for dusky to deep skin tone. And so I was out and I shopped a lot for lipsticks. Yeah, and that was the reason why I opted for Jhumki, which was a mauvey purple kind of shade. And then this has all of my lipsticks over here. So let's begin with this pouch itself first. This pouch I got free with my NYX purchase, which was done before lockdown. I ordered two SMLCs over here, which is first one is Budapest and the second one is Rome. I got Budapest because this is Stacey's favorite SMLC shade, and so I had to get this. While I thought Rome looked a good, beautiful brown shade online, and as far as the swatches I saw, so I got this. Sadly, it isn't a brown, like it would be kind of browny on very fair to fair skin tones, but on us, it is a pink kind of shade. So I'll just swatch Rome right here. So that is Rome. And the second shade I got was Budapest, which is a very beautiful mauvey pink color. It looks absolutely gorgeous on our dusky skin. So that's Budapest and that's Rome. To be true, the formula on these and the Miss Claire ones are so bang on. I would say do not waste your money on this if you can find a very close shade or similar shade in the Miss Claire ones, because dude, they are just knock off, seriously. That's the reason why I have so many Miss Claire SMLCs. And now I had seen people loving Miss Claire SMLCs, but not many review videos and swatch videos online which did have proper brown shades from their range and swatches of those shades. So I thought to pick whatever felt to me more on the brownier nude side. So I picked up four. So the first shade I have is 14, then I have 17, I have 54 and 63. I already own 55, 58, and so I did swatch all of these in natural light, and I would leave the video link in the description. You can check them out. But these were the four SMLCs that I got. For the swatches, kindly watch that video, otherwise this is gonna be way too long. So those were the four Miss Claire SMLCs. After that, I was having this lipstick in my wish list for the longest time, but every time I was about to check out, I used to debate whether or not to get that, but always I used to remove it and add it back to my wish list. But this time I thought we're gonna get it, but I chose other shades instead. So it was the Rimmel Stay Matte Liquid Lip Color from Rimmel London, and I had the shade Love Bite in my cart, but I heard that Love Bite is a very close dupe to Claire Underwood from Sugar in the Matte as Hell lip crayon, and I already have that shade and I didn't want repetitives at the moment, and so I thought to invest my coin in some other shade and try out the formula first. So firstly, I got this shade, which is 723 Trouble Maker. Oh my god, like oh my god. Shade, the formula, the weightlessness, oh my god, I freaking love this. I so am in love with this formula. Like, it is so lightweight on your lips, you do not even feel like you're wearing something, and when you actually touch your lips, it is very smooth, velvet soft. I am wearing the second shade right now on my lips, and I can say it's so velvet soft, it does not settle in the fine lines. This lasts so long, you guys. Like, I was hugging that day and this was still there with just slight bit of fading right in the inner corner of my lips, but oh my god, I just love this. I don't know why do they call it a lip color. I feel like it is having a very moussey whipped kind of texture, and even the formula is very moussey whipped like. So that's the shade Trouble Maker, a beautiful mauve toned brown, and I love it. So love the formula that I had to pick up this one in my second order. Now this shade is 860 Urban Affair. I am wearing this right now on my lips. Look at the shade, you guys. It is such a beautiful mauve purple shade, like wow. It is not like too much bangany purpley, you know that kind of color. It is not too much purple and it is not very mauve. It is just like the subtle kind of mauve purple one could like carry even for the everyday chores, and I love it. Have any space left? Yeah. And even the applicator, dude, it is arrow shaped applicator with slight bit of angle given to it, which just fits on your lips so perfectly. Love it. Okay, after that, you see in this Nykaa bill, I have one more lipstick. Let me tell you what happened with this and why is it plastered in this way. So this is the Blue Heaven Sapphire Matte Lip Color. To be true, when I got this, I wasn't expecting Blue Heaven packaging to be such sleek and bougie, but Blue Heaven is playing no games, girl. Love the packaging on this. So I got it in the shade Naughty Cocoa 106, and this is how it looks. It does have a diamond cut design right on the top. But what happened was, as I opened this up, from here the oil started separating out of the tube. I don't know why always I am the one who gets these bad faulty Blue Heaven products. I don't know why it does happen only with me that I get broken Blue Heaven lipsticks, broken, leaking. Anyways, so what I did was basically I just used this bill because that was the first thing that came in my hand over there when I was just sanitizing everything, and I just cleaned up all the oil that was leaking. That's how the applicator looks. The applicator again is something different that Blue Heaven did. It is a very slim yet long tapered flat applicator, and that is how the shade looks. I will swatch it here. You see it's a dark plum mauve purple, not mauve, it's more on the purpley side, and that is how it looks. The shade is very beautiful. It looks very gorgeous on my lips as well. Dries completely matte. It is not sticky. It is slightly drying because it is a liquid lip, but I'm fine till the time I do nicely prep my lips. But yeah, the shade is really beautiful, and the formula is, I feel, one of the best till date that I have tried from Blue Heaven. So I really do like this elegance range from them, so I have that one. And the last purchase was this lip color from Faces Canada. It's their Ultime Pro Long Stay Liquid Matte Powder Matte Long Stay Light on Lips Lipstick. Long name. Okay, so I got this in the shade a Deep Nude 01. That I saw Shohini's swatches of these liquid lipsticks on her Instagram, and this looked such a beautiful mauve brown shade on her, and I was like, dude, I need to get it. It is so beautiful, so beautiful. And so I, you know, just checked out with this lipstick so quick. This wasn't on a great discount. This retails for MRP $7.99, but I guess I got it for 600 or something. But I don't know why does this happen with me. To be true, this is such a beautiful shade, you guys, but not for us dusky skin girls. If you're fair to medium skin tone, I would definitely recommend the shade Deep Nude for you guys. I really wished I could actually wear this, but when I wear it, it is exactly the same shade as the pigmentation of my lips, and so when I wear it, I look as if I am poisoned or something. Kind of shade. I really like the formula though of this one. It does stay for a really good amount of time. Again, that soft velvet matte kind of finish, completely transfer proof, does not bleed, budge, smudge, settle in the fine lines or look crumbly, not at all sticky. Love the formula, but the shade, not for me. That I finish all of the items and products and essentials, if I had any, but that was all that I shopped from Nykaa. I wasted a lot of money, I feel, in some of the lipsticks which did not end up working for me, but that's how my life is, to be true. But that's basically my job, to find out the best, what would work for you, so that you guys do not waste your hard-earned coin. And so I'm always there for the rescue. Also have my sugar orders coming next, whenever I would receive them. I haven't yet received my orders from them, you know, because of the corona. I most of my orders were stuck, but yeah, whenever I receive them, I would do a separate sugar makeup haul. So for seeing that, you should be subscribed, yeah? So don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet subscribed, and I would meet you guys super soon in my next video. And whatever I'm wearing on my face and all these deets are always mentioned, yeah, in the description. So if you feel like, before commenting, go ahead and check out the description. I always try and make your work simpler by detailing all the stuff that I am having. Stay home, stay responsible, and namaste, and keep running. Oh my god, I miss saying this so much.